Hi everybody, I'm Jeff from Missouri Wind and Solar, and today we're going to talk about micro wind turbines. Are they worth it? Are they better than solar, the same as solar, or just not worth it at all? This video is in response to a guy in Arizona, and we'll just call him Handy Guy. And the title of his video is Micro Wind Turbines, Are They Worth It? Off-Grid Solar. Now, he made that title for a reason, and the reason being, I think it's just clickbait. He says, micro wind turbines aren't worth it, they don't work. But solar does work, and it works awesome. So where does Handy Guy get his information from? Well, turns out, he just gets it off the internet. Handy Guy has never owned a wind turbine or had any experience with them at all. But in his video, micro wind turbines, are they worth it? He professes to be some sort of expert on micro wind turbines. Well, turns out Handy Guy lives in St. David, Arizona, and that's where his off-grid home project is going on, which actually is a really nice project. He does rain harvesting, solar panels, even lives in a tiny home there. He also gives you a lot of information on solar panels. And I find a lot of his information is misleading or just totally incorrect. So what I'm going to do in this video is give you all of the points he makes why you should buy a wind turbine and why solar is better. And I'm going to give you the counterpoint, why wind turbines are worth it. So where does Handy Guy live? St. David, Arizona. And that's located in a valley. And how do I really know anything at all about St. David, Arizona? I lived there for 8 years in St. David, Arizona, and I probably lived just down the road from where he's building his off-grid home. I had a concrete business out there, ornamental concrete, so I knew the area quite well. Well, for him, having a wind turbine down in St. David really isn't worth it. Lots of sun, lots of dust, I can attest to that. Wind, not much, not there. So that gives you a little idea of where his off-grid project is and who might know something a little bit about it and whether he can actually have a wind turbine or not. If he called me and said, Jeff, you want to sell me a wind turbine, and I knew where he lived, I'd say absolutely not. It won't work for you. Well, Handy Guy in Arizona says, isn't this beautiful just to have a solar array on the ground? 25-year warranty on the solar panels, and absolutely maintenance free. Wind turbines, on the other hand, have bearings, lots of maintenance needed, and they don't last. And they're just plain unsightly, aesthetically unpleasing to look at. Wind turbines. So, what's misleading about that statement, there is no maintenance on solar panels, well, that's a flat out lie, or the guy just doesn't know what he's talking about, and I think it's the latter. This is a solar tracker. Now it's very easy to mow underneath this solar tracker. It doesn't take up any yard space, but you still have maintenance on a solar tracker. You have gears, actuators, electrical lines, nuts and bolts everywhere that have to be checked to make sure nothing is coming loose and everything is functioning properly. It doesn't take up any land space. Very costly. So trackers, very expensive. A solar panel setup like this takes up a lot of yard space, and there is a maintenance to it, contrary to what he said. If you live where it's dusty, these panels will get covered with dust, and that dust has to be cleaned off. Solar panels get covered with snow, and you got to get that snow off. Now, ground mount, it's not that hard to get the snow off. You need a big broom, like a push broom, or something like that. But now put solar panels on the roof of your house, they get covered with snow, how do you get it off? Well, you got to get up there on the roof and sweep them off. So that the idea there is no maintenance on solar is totally false. Up solar panels, even ground mount, and forgetting about them, it's not going to happen. They do get covered with dust. That dust has to be washed off or it'll degrade, or you'll lose power. They get covered with snow, they get covered with ice. If they're on the roof, you have to get on your roof and be able to clean that snow off or do a no power until it eventually melts off. and it may not, depending on where you live. No maintenance on solar panels sitting on the ground like this, also not true. If you're mowing around a solar panel set like this, you have to be careful not to pick up a rock with your lawnmower and put it through one of the panels and bust it. You can also get into a horrible hailstorm, and if the hail is large enough, can destroy that solar panel array. So where he says they last forever, maintenance free, totally false. He then goes on to say that there's a lot of maintenance to wind turbines. They have bearings and other things. Yes, all motors have bearings. They seldom, if ever, need replacing. We have very seldom ever sold a set of bearings for our wind turbines. Towers can be tilted down for greasing and blade checking every year or so. Roof mounts can be checked by just simply walking on the roof, checking for a loose blade or any bolts, maybe putting some grease on the pole if that's what you need. But there is literally not much, if any, maintenance on a wind turbine at all. One thing you don't have to worry about is a hailstorm on a wind turbine. Wind turbines can survive a hailstorm. Snow doesn't bother wind turbines, dust don't bother wind turbines, and neither does rain. Well, he then goes on to say about wind turbine towers cost a lot of money, and you need a mechanical engineer and a lot of people to do it. Well, that's simply not so. Almost all wind turbine towers are built by homeowners, and they don't get an engineer to do it. And as far as cost, just for instance, this tilt-up tower that we built here at the store, cables, piping and all, I think I got about $500 into it. The pipe is used pipe. It was pipe that I got from a steel company, and this pipe was used for oil drilling. And after so many hours of use, they get rid of it. And so we get about $500 into this, and it didn't take any more than one person to build it. You also say they take up a lot of space. Well, as you can see out here, this is a 65-foot tower, and it doesn't really take up any space at all. Just where the gin pole is, the base, but the cables don't really bother me, and they don't really take up any space. Ground mounts take up a lot of ground space for solar panels. Then he goes on to say how nice solar panels look and how ugly a wind turbine is, and they're aesthetically unpleasing to the eye, and he really hates the look of a wind turbine. Myself, I find wind turbines interesting to look at and pretty cool. Well, I don't know about you, but I find watching a wind turbine operate, kind of swirling back and forth and the blades turning, is kind of fun to do. Watching a solar panel is pretty boring. It's kind of like watching paint dry. Watts are ground mounted, and they require pretty much no maintenance whatsoever. He says wind turbines are not cost effective. Just add more solar panels to compensate for a wind turbine. Well, how can you compensate for a wind turbine if you don't have any sun, cloudy days, overcast? Wind can blow 24 hours a day, and a wind turbine could be putting power into your battery bank. He says when you don't have the sun for too many days and your battery bank gets low, just buy more batteries and add to your bank. Well, batteries are very expensive, and unless you have enough wind and solar energy or hydropower to keep that battery bank fully charged the way it should be, that battery bank is going to go bad on you. A wind turbine can be running all night, keeping your battery bank charged up when solar doesn't work. Thus, the need for more batteries is not necessary. So how can a guy that's never owned a wind turbine or even experienced using one give you advice on whether a wind turbine is worth it or not? I don't think he can. A guy in Hawaii recently that lives totally off-grid just did a video of his wind turbine he's got up on a 10-foot pipe. He lives on the coastline, and that wind turbine is screaming all the time. A 10-foot pipe with a few guy wires on it cost him literally nothing to do. He then shows you wind charts or wind map of the U.S. and says there's very few places you could have wind. Well, or that you have wind, with the exception of Wyoming. Well, that's just BS. There's all kinds of places across the U.S. that people have plenty of wind, and it's not just the Midwest. It's the East Coast, West Coast, up north and down south. More information from the handy guy. More misinformation from the handy guy. Now, Freya, for instance, lives in the Netherlands, and she only gets about 4 hours worth of sun in a day, certain times of the year, so solar doesn't work for them, handy guy. She bought herself a wind turbine, and they have wind all the time there. So with the wind and the solar together, they work great for her. Now, people up in Canada even complain they don't have enough sun to make solar worthwhile up there. But they've got plenty of wind, so they use wind turbines. Now, the handy guy was even going to go to Hannibal, Missouri in 2018 and speak up there at some convention about solar. And I said, I really hate to see the guy do that because he's going to spread the same misinformation up there. Wind, solar, and hydro should all coexist together. They all work together, and they complement each other. It is not a solar world, according to the handy guy it is, but he is full of it. All in all, I'm not knocking solar or not knocking wind. It depends on where you live in the country, what's best for you. Some places, wind is excellent for you and solar is no good. Some places, like the Southwest, where Handy Guy lives, solar is the way for him to go and not a wind turbine. So it just depends on where you live in the United States. Do not pay any attention to those wind maps. They're BS, most of them. So I never have paid attention to them. And people that lived in some of those zones that said they didn't have any wind, they've contacted me and they said, geez, you ought to tell that to my wind turbine. It hasn't stopped creating power since the day I put it up. Maintenance, we've had guys that's had these wind turbines up for 10 years and had to do no maintenance on them. But they took them down every year or two and greased up the pole a little bit, checked the blades, back up they went. Or even maybe put a new paint job on them. So anyway, I'm Jeff from Missouri Wind and Solar. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you don't, give me a thumbs down. I'd appreciate it if you'd subscribe to my channel. And if you want updates of any of my new videos, just hit the little bell that's down there in that corner, and you'll get updated every time I put up a new video. And I will see you on my next video.